Hello friends, welcome to the next lecture in the series of Arduino Less Arduino, and today we'll be talking about the interfacing of ultrasonic sensor and how it can be used for distance measurement. I've already explained you what ultrasonic sensor is, its pin diagram, in my previous lectures, but here also we'll see about the waveform of ultrasonic sensors or how actually the sensor works. In this sensor, there are four pins. One is VCC, trigger, which is the output pin, echo is the input pin, and ground is the ground pin. So VCC is connected to 5 volts, ground is connected to ground, and here trigger is connected to pin number 8 of Arduino, and echo is connected to pin number 7 of Arduino. Fine, this was about the pin interfacing, and now let's see the waveform. In a waveform, if we see a trigger is an output which is to be given for 10 microseconds. Once I give a trigger of 10 microseconds, that sensor, ultrasonic sensor, there is one transmitter and this is receiver, suppose. So transmitter will transmit a burst of 8 cycles. Got it? A burst of 8 cycle, which is ultrasonic wave. Now, the moment it starts giving the burst, echo will go high, and when this burst are received back, echo pin will go low. Means this high to low on the echo pin will decide the time period of transmitted wave and received back. So I have to divide it by 2 to get the exact distance. So I hope this waveform is clear. In this waveform, I have to give a trigger for 10 microseconds. Once I give trigger, it will send a burst of 8 cycles of ultrasonic wave, and the echo pin will go high, which is read by the Arduino. Now, when this burst is returning back, is reflected by the object, and it is returned back, its pin will go low. So a high to low, a pulse is generated, which you can see in the waveform, and that pulse will decide the time period of transmitter till reception. Fine. So let's see the code part of it. And in this code part, trigger is connected to pin number 8, which is defined as a constant integer. Same constant integer, echo pin number 7. And for distance, we have taken float. And setup, I have taken a serial.begin 9600. Now serial.begin, so it's for serial communication, I have already told you. So here in this serial monitor, you can see the distance. And 9600 is the baud rate, that is rate of transmission of serial communication. Now trigger pin is defined as output and echo pin is defined as input. So to define input and output, I have to use function called as pin mode. Now in a loop function, now see this, digital write trigger as low, wait for 5 microseconds. Now first the pin is low, you can see in the waveform, first the pin is low, then a trigger pin is made high. Fine, so the pulse goes high on the trigger. Delay of 10 microseconds, will wait that pulse for 10 microseconds, you can see in the waveform. And then it is again made low, so it is generating a pulse. The moment it is giving a pulse, now the transmitter start transmitting the waveform and we read that pulse on the echo pin. So I am taking distance equal to pulse in echo comma high. Fine. So it is waiting to measure that particular waveform. So it will read that waveform. The time period in the distance will be there in the distance variable. So the distance will be equal to distance by 58. Now, actually it is distance equal to the time duration, which is there, into 0.034 divided by 2. So this is 0.034 divided by 2 is equal to division by 58. And on serial communication, I am printing distance in centimeters. Fine. And then I'll wait for some time, that is 200 milliseconds, and then again I'll repeat the loop. So let's see the demonstration of it. I hope this code is clear. Now start simulation. Now the moment you see the simulation, distance is 89.50 centimeters. So I'll click here. Now this is the object. See, the distance is increasing in the serial. This is F kept here. The distance has increased to 294.07 centimeters. The moment I come closer, the distance has changed, 39.86 meters. Fine. So you can see the distance even here also in the setup. So the moment I go back, it is increasing, and the moment I come back, it is decreasing. So this is how I can find out the distance. Now, depending upon this distance, I can take certain actions. I may blow the buzzer, I may glow the LED, or if needed, I can take some actions. So let's see one more demonstration in which ultrasonic sensor is interfaced with LCD. Now this is the complete setup of interfacing of LCD and ultrasonic sensor. Fine, first let's see the complete interfacing. Now LCD is interfaced. I've already explained you how to interface the LCD. Now here, to control the brightness, a potentiometer is used. Pin number 10 is register select. Pin number 9 is enable pin of LCD. Then pin number 11 is connected to eco pin. And pin number 12 is connected to LED. But this functionality is not implemented. This is an assignment for you, that after some distance, this LED should glow. So after that distance, LED should glow, and before that distance, LED should be off. And then trigger pin is connected to pin number 13. Now what I did here is I have combined both the setups of the LCD as well as ultrasonic sensor. So let's see the simulation part. So here you can see target distance as 21.8 centimeters. The moment I move away, see this distance is increasing. So if I go come nearer, the distance has decreased. So I hope this demonstration is clear. You can try code writing at your end, which is an assignment for you. And see, if I rotate this, see the display has been switched off because the brightness has been reduced. And now if I increase this, so now if I increase the intensity, see it is displaying properly. So in my previous videos, I have explained you how you can connect a resistance here. And in this video, I'm explaining you how to connect the potentiometer. So I hope this is clear. Stay safe and wait for my next lectures on Arduino-less Arduino. Take care, and if you like this videos, please don't forget to subscribe the channel, like the channel, and hit the bell notification so that you will get the updates of my new videos uploaded. Take care, stay safe.